Hey everybody, Kyrie091 hanging out with you. Boy oh boy, are we gonna have big fun today playing some more Final Fantasy Tactics. So this hopefully will prove to be a much shorter episode than the last ridiculous episode. Real quick, let's take a look at some information about Cardinal Draeklaw, the guy who is the head of Lionel Castle. He's second only to the head of Glabados Church, so he's apparently a pretty high up guy in the church. Let's see. There you go. So he's the leader of Lionel Castle, which is where we were going to be going to find a, you know, asylum, I guess, for the princess. But real quick, actually, this episode, I want to just do something else real quick, and then we'll go down there next time. I want to show you about propositions. So what are propositions? The bars, starting in Chapter 2, offer what's called propositions. By the way, before we talk about propositions, Kokobo had a baby. Boko, our Kokobo, had himself a baby named Europi, I guess. Oh, I don't wonder where he's gone. Bye. Yeah, it's good. All right, so he's gone. So, let's go over what propositions are all about. We can actually do one real quick. Trap of the Bandits. 600 gil to get more info on this job? Yeah, let's go do that. Who do we want to send? I want to send McNeil, who I made into an archer, by the way. He was our monk. He's now going to be an archer for a little while. Ingram, who's the chemist. And Angelica, who's our priest. So they're all three going to go on this little mission here. We're going to give them 13 days to get the job done. And we're going to push OK. So now the job is underway. If we take a look at our formation screen, these guys are gone, leaving temp. We cannot use them in combat. If I were to get into a random battle, they would not be available for me to use. In fact, if I were to get into a random battle, the only people I could use would be Ramza, Diaz, and the Kokobo, because these two are both guests. But fortunately for me, I'm not going to get a random battle. Two. Three. Because I have these two spots here, I can walk back and forth. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11, 12, 13, and that's it. We're done. So let's go back to the bar, and we will get a report on the job to see how they did. Let's hear about it. We left Order Trade City. We joined the party to defeat the bandits. This job's a gift from God, says Ingram. That means it's going to be successful. It's possible to fail these jobs if I don't know. It doesn't happen often, but it can happen. The enemy outnumbered us. It was our very best. As a result, we defeated him. We were cleaning up after the battle. And we found a big treasure box. Ingram opened it, and inside was a bag stuffed with gil. So this job's a big success. This is the way, says McNeil. So there's our report. The bonus that we got was just a bunch of extra gil. There are other bonuses you can get, too, but my favorite's always extra gil. And everybody got some job points. You can see there, McNeil got 150. Ingram and Angelica both got 163. So there's no jobs right now we can get from the bar here. So let's take a look at those job points we just... Oh my god. Oh, our Kokobo has been busy. Look, we even have a little egg, a little baby Kokobo. And we have a black Kokobo. Black Kokobos are pretty cool. They can fly. And they have a move called Coco Ball, which is like this fireball thing that they shoot out. So it's like a ranged attack. I'll keep that black Kokobo. What's this guy's name? Say that name. Misericordi. Misericordi. I don't know. He's gone. Bye. And you're gone, too. We'll keep Boko, and we'll keep the black one, but we're going to destroy the egg, though. So let's take a look at their job points. Well, we got some archer points here. The main reason I wanted him to be an archer was not even so much for the purpose of having an archer. Although archers are kind of cool, and concentrate is friggin' rad. The main reason I wanted him as an archer is to unlock the thief job class, and we did that now. I think I'll leave him as an archer a little while longer, though. Why not? You know, they're good. Chemist. Got a lot of job points for chemists. What should we do with him? Throw item. That's what I want for him. And I don't know anything else I might buy. I guess I might buy High Ether or Elixir. Really, I don't care about most of this other stuff. Ever. Yeah, so let's take a look at Angelica's priest points here. Angelica has 400 priest points. She can buy Cure 3. We could save up for Holy. Holy? What do you think? What's Wall do? Protect and Shell in one spell. That's kind of cool. I don't really have anything pressing I want to buy. Cure 3 is pretty good, but I don't know that we're going to need it anytime soon. I don't know. Maybe we're done having her as a priest. A lot of time mage points, but like we said before, I don't really have much I want to do in the way of time magic. Teleport. Yeah. So, what I want to do with her now is pretty unprecedented for me. Oh, do I even dare? I'm going to make her into an oracle. I've never used an oracle before. Never, ever, ever. In fact, I despise oracles. They have one good move. Paralyze. That's it. It adds don't act. Everything else is freaking worthless. Oh, great. Oh, I can cast a spell to blind somebody. That's going to be super useful. Oh, well, why don't I just do this one that silences them so they can't... Oracles are freaking worthless. But I do want to make her into an oracle for other reasons that will make sense very soon, I hope. We have that power wrist. I don't want my oracle to use it. Let's go into Dorder Trade City and see if they have any sticks for sale. Yes, they do. So, here's the one cool thing about oracles is they can use these here. These are called sticks. And they are only used by oracles and calculators. Calculators are pretty rad. Sticks are cool. They have a greater range than most staves. They can reach up two spaces in front of you. So yeah, we bought a stick for our oracle. That's kind of cool. I think we need a better shield for somebody. No, we're okay. And let's leave the store. I am going to make my way up to Igros Castle, and hopefully we'll be able to get some other jobs up there we can do real quick. So let's do that. You think we can get all the way up there without getting in a fight? Oh, biscuits and gravy. Should have known. All right. I mostly want to go there to see what kind of swords they have and to see if they have anything for the, like, a new bow or anything like that. Okay, so I'm going to bring the black Kokobo with this time. No, sorry, Diaz. You're being replaced by a Kokobo yet again. I actually want to show off what the black Kokobo is all about before we get up to Igros Castle. And I might do just a tiny bit of grinding while we're passing through. I don't know. We'll see. What song do we got? Oh, we've heard this one before. Random Waltz. There's only one battle song we have. One random battle song we haven't heard yet. There are only three random battle songs. We've heard this one, Random Waltz. And we've heard the one called Desert Land. I did a whole episode on that one, but then in the last episode, right before we did Zerkal Falls, in that random battle with where I was showing off the Kokobos, that song was playing there too. So there's only three enemies here. This shouldn't be too much of a challenge, but like I said, I kind of want to demonstrate what the black Kokobo is all about here. So let's tag him with haste. Oh my god, low percentage. Let's move you over here. Hopefully you have a better percentage of hitting that yourself than... Alright, basic skill, throw a stone at the archer. Oh, he's gonna counterattack. No, he can't, we're too close. Yes, archers do counterattack with their arrows. If you hit an archer and he can target you, he will shoot you back. Okay. And let's move the archer right out here, why not? You know, I kind of had a bad feeling like this would happen. Alright. Oh, you know what? He can do chakra. I gave him punch art because he was a monk, so he has a few good punch arts. So chakra is actually going to be really good because he can heal still. Let's see about that haste. So far, so good. Ah, you piece of crap. So... Black Kokobos, even though they can fly and they have, make them fly real quick. Put them right here. See, they fly. And if you are riding one of them, yes, you can fly. The coolest part is they have this ranged attack called Coco Ball, though. Which I really like. So let's check it out. Coco Ball, here it comes. Boom! Nice. So yeah, Black Kokobos, pretty friggin' handy. You know, the flying part's pretty rad, too. Yeah. let's put that on the panel. Because that guy's going to move, but the goblin's not going to move. And the Kokobo will counterattack. Oh, God, he hits hard. Oh, my God, he just did 70 damage. Oh, his base, his, like, plane attack just did 70 damage. Oh, my God. Let's throw a stone at this archer. Hey, yeah. Didn't work. Let's see if this works. I did. Don't act. Nice. Job level up. Perfect. I don't want to ride the Kokobo. Just accumulate one time. All right, let's move over here and shoot that cat thingy. There you go. And you gained a job level. Very nice. See, it's funny when you change to new job classes you've never used, everybody starts gaining job levels like crazy. So, here's what I was saying about the attack range on this weapon. Check this out. Look it. You can hit two... You can hit two spaces in any direction. So I can hit this guy. And the cool thing is he can't counterattack because I'm too far away. He can't reach me. So, yeah, I like it. Let's go over here and finish this guy off. How are we going to finish him off? Oh, you know how. Kokoball, of course. Got him. Nice. So that black Kokobo, man, I don't know about getting rid of him. He's pretty freaking cool. Deal with that! Oh, we darknessed her. Oh, no. Oh, no. Alright. Accumulate. It's almost time to change Ramza from a knight to something else, I'm starting to feel like. Dun, 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 dun. Chakra. Oh, I didn't show you Stigma Magic. That's a monk ability, and look what it does. It gets rid of all those status ailments. Pretty much every status ailment in the game, except for a couple. Stigma Magic is a great move because it seriously can cure almost anything. Wait. You. Go up here. And whack this guy in the face. Just like that. And he's gonna run away. Why not? Why wouldn't he? Alright, Kokobo. And the black Kokobo, in addition to having Koko Ball and Koko Attack, he has Koko Asuna, which heals status ailments. Those status ailments listed there. So the black Kokobo is actually pretty friggin' handy. Ba-boom, ba-boom. Alright, sorry to show you an entire other random battle on camera here, but... I didn't have much else going on this episode, and I wanted you to see what this random battle was going to look like, so here it is. Actually, I can just chakra again. I was going to attack Ramza, but I don't have to do that. I can just chakra. And Ramza hopefully can finish off this goblin, and we can be done with this random battle and go up to Igress Castle and take a look at... Oh, God damn it. Alright. Finish the job, Oracle. So the Oracle was actually kind of handy in that. Oh, by the way, when things are don't acted, they can't block you with their shields and stuff. Don't act removes things like your shield and your weapon guard and all that, so you're a lot more susceptible to physical, to any kind of attacks when you have don't act inflicted on you. Alright, so, I may have actually accomplished everything I wanted to do with the Oracle in that battle. I don't know if I really want to do anything else. I don't care about this monster egg. Yeah. I don't know, dude. Their spells are so bad. Their spells are so worthless. They don't have anything worth getting. I don't know. Life Drain's kind of cool. I mean, I'll keep the Oracle for a little while, I guess. And as for you, I think you're done as an archer. I wanted Concentrate. I got Concentrate. We'll go check out the bows and stuff anyhow, though. Alright, and do you have any propositions? Yes, you do. Gorilla Golden Volcano. We'll come back there and do that in a minute after we have checked out our... Ooh. Platina Dagger. Coral Sword. Lightning Elemental. How cool. And the Night Killer, that's the bow Algus had that inflicts darkness. That's cool. Ice bow, I like it. I definitely want... Ooh! Javelin! You don't say. Okay, I want a javelin. Just in case I need it later. Yeah. Let's equip some stuff. So, you are done in your career as an archer because you are now a thief. Bum, bum, bum. All right, we got us a thief, guys. I'll configure him between this episode and the next one. You're gonna stay as an oracle for a while. I think I might be done having Ramza as a knight. I didn't want to like master this job class right now or anything. Yeah, I think I might make him into a geomancer, but we'll do that next time. Because we're out of time for this episode. So thank you so much for watching. This is Kyrie091, wishing you a wonderful day, and we will see you next time for more Let's Play Final Fantasy Tactics. I'm probably going to do a job or two here, just to get some JP and get going, and then next time we'll be heading down towards Lionel Castle. Alright, bye!